whence thou art fallen, and repent, and do the first works, or else I will come unto thee quickly, and will remove thy candlestick out of his place, except thou repent. But I have a few things against thee, because thou hast there them that hold the doctrine of Balaam, who taught Balak to cast a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed unto idols, and to commit fornication. So hast thou also them that hold the doctrine of the Nicolaitans, which thing I hate. Repent, or else I will come unto thee quickly, and will fight against them with the sword of my mouth. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. To him that overcometh will I give to eat of the hidden manna, and will give him a white stone, and in the stone a new name written, which no man knoweth, saving he that receiveth it. I don't know about you, but I am so glad that we have a merciful God. We serve a merciful God. He sits high and he looks low. His word tells us that he looks on the heart of man. Let us do like David and examine our hearts today. We understand that Romans 3:23 tells us that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. But thank God for his grace and for his mercy. Even while we were yet in our sins, Christ died for us. He came down from his heavenly abode and he took our place and he gave it all. He gave it all for us. He sacrificed it all at Calvary's cross. And yet, like the children of Israel, we tend to walk in our own ways. We say with our mouths, yes, I will obey. I will follow the Lord, as Joshua said. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And all of the children of Israel, after they heard the words of Moses, and after they heard what Joshua had to say, they said, yes, we will follow the Lord. We will obey his commands. But at every turn, you can see that they went their own way. They served and they worshiped other gods. God took them out of the hand of the Egyptians with a mighty and a strong hand, and he wanted to bless them. He called them his people and he made them their own. And yet they decided, we can do it our way. Isn't that just like us today? Isn't that just what we do today? We have God's word, God's authority. God is our supreme ruler. He is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. We are his people. He has given us time and space to repent and to turn around. And today, I don't know if you can hear his voice. Maybe you feel like you have sunken so low that there is just no hope. Well, I'm here to tell you today that it is not too late. If you are hearing my voice, as the scripture said today, if you hear my voice, harden not your heart as in the day of provocation. Let's not provoke the Lord anymore. The word says, and grieve not the Holy Spirit of God. We have grieved his Holy Spirit time and time again, falling into sin and making choices that we know beforehand we should not make. But oh, I'm so glad for God's grace. I'm so glad for his mercy that says if you would just stop what you're doing, if you would just contemplate, think about, meditate on, think about it, and then have a change of heart, have a change of mind. Just turn around, turn back to me, repent, change your mind. I'm not talking about repentance that we do and we see going on. Sometimes we have witnessed people publicly repenting of doing things wrong, and then they turn back around and fall into the same sins over and over. No, that's not what repentance is. To repent means to have a change of mind, have a change of heart. Just turn away from it. Repent. Turn your heart back to the Lord. Give him the praise. Give him the honor and the glory, not just with your lips, but with your life. He's calling you. He's telling you to come come back, he said in his word, he's even married to the backslider. So understand today that it is not too late. Heed his call. Heed his warning. Don't be like that woman Jezebel in Revelation, the 2nd chapter and the 20th verse. Answer his call today. He said, I gave her time and space to repent of her fornication, but she did not. Don't let it be said too late. Turn around and repent. Turn around. Give your heart. Give your life back to the Lord. No matter where you are today, no matter who you are, I'm here to let you know that Jesus Christ has already died for your sins on Calvary's cross. Turn back around and repent. Give him your heart. Turn back around before it's too late. But what does it say? The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. That if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Romans 10:8-10. So you see, it's right there in the word. It is plain right before your eyes. If you would just open up your eyes and see what the Lord is saying today, it is not too late for you to turn